Starting lineups brought to you by Kubota and Shane Noel will take Caleb Boone's place in the starting lineup. He only averages 6 minutes per game, so a huge loss for the UNLV Running Rebels, led by Kevin Krueger in his third year now as the head coach, where he played for UNLV under his father back in the 06-07 season. Brian Dutcher in his seventh year at San Diego State. Done a wonderful job. 25th year overall at San Diego State for Dutch, of course, under Steve Fisher for so long. And what a great rivalry this is. And it's been one-sided in the Mountain West tournament, as San Diego State in the conference tournament has won 8 in a row against UNLV. Rebels have not defeated San Diego State in the conference tournament since 2003.
Only Villanova has more wins on a neutral court than San Diego State does on this court.
Good crowd here this afternoon for our 4-5 matchup in the Mountain West Conference Tournament. UNLV in white controls the opening tip, and right away DJ Thomas for two.
I mean, I've seen him a lot on film, but when you see him live, that was an explosive move there. He's got that ball on a string. Both these teams among the nation's best in man-to-man defense.
Three ball for Jay Powell is no good. The rebound is scooped up by the Rebels.
Yeah, they put Jay Powell into the lineup, took Reese Waters out because they feel like they need the length and he's a better shot blocker, which they needed.
Rob Whaley on the wing. And that shot won't go. The rebound to Powell.
The thing we got to really keep an eye on in this game, Andrew, is San Diego State on the offensive glass. They are tremendous there, and now a little bit undersized, this UNLV team.
Darion Trammell to the hoop. Scoop shot won't go. Offensive rebound by Jay Powell right there, but he couldn't follow. And now a tie-up. And the possession arrow will stay with the Aztecs. Our officials, Randy McCall, Randy Richardson, and Justin Chamion.
Yeah, the Rebels are really going to have to gang rebound in this game, because when you lose a guy like Caleb Boone, who was a really good rebounder, one of their big guys, it's tough. Hopefully he'll be able to play a little bit.
Caleb averaging 5.4 rebounds per game. It's a lot to replace in his absence. Here's the Mountain West's top scorer in Ladee, and his first shot attempt won't go.
And I think it's good for the Rebels to push it up initially, because scoring against this half-court defense of San Diego State is always a humongous challenge.
Aztecs have started this game 0 for 4 from the floor. Here's Thomas. Around Powell for two.
And one thing you don't see is San Diego State. That's two baskets right. That's two scores by UNLV right at the basket. Those are usually really hard to get against San Diego State.
Lamont Butler into the corner to Powell. Extra pass to Micah Parrish. His three won't go. And San Diego State still without a field goal here.
You know, they're a 30% three-point shooting team in the league games, and that's really their Achilles heel, no doubt.
And poor starts have been the Achilles heel of late. They have trailed after 5 minutes in 10 of their last 11 games. And against UNLV, last time out, they started the game 0 for 13.
You know what that speaks to, too? They got back in the game, and they were 2 for 25 at one point in that half because of their defense.
Fell behind by 17 points.
And here comes the double. Deedon Thomas, DJ Thomas, we'll call him now.
Parrish, three. And the rebound is Shane Noel's.
And normally UNLV is a walk it up the floor type team, but I think in this game, they got to go when they can.
Boone feeding it down low. Whaley couldn't get a handle on it. And out of bounds to San Diego State.
That was a good pass. I think Whaley's got to come down with that one.
And how about this? Caleb Boone is going to give it a go on the floor for UNLV.
Well, I guess the thing to do is to go try it early when he's loose and see how it goes.
So he's the first sub off the bench. And a whistle inside and a foul is called. And that's going to go on Caleb's twin brother Keelan. Oh no, it's actually called on Noel.
Foul number three, Noel, his first.
You know, it'll be interesting to see what Caleb can give today. One thing he gives is at least some size out there a little bit and put a body on somebody to box out.
First field goal of the day for the Aztecs belongs to Ladie. It's the right ankle for Boone as he hobbles down to the other end of the floor. He rolled it in the first half on Saturday at Nevada.
Oh, you don't want to stop there.
And a turnover. Trammell missed it. Rebound inside to Butler for two.
Butler's a really physical guard, but the worst thing you could do against San Diego State is stop your dribble right across half court because they're coming after you there.
Thomas from the free throw line. A foul is called. And that takes us to our first media timeout. So Caleb Boone trying to give it a go despite rolling his right ankle a few days ago. We're tied at four early in Vegas.
College basketball on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by Kubota. Together we do more. By AT&T. We believe connecting changes everything. And by Geico. For all your insurance needs, it's easy to Geico.
Our lives flashing before us, literally. How about that? We have come in here for a long time, Laugh, and it's so good to be with you for another Mountain West tournament. A
lot of water under that bridge, huh? Absolutely.
Oh, man, the COVID picture. And then actually, as we said in the first game, there was a Mountain West tournament in 2020. We were here not knowing what was happening the following week, and now good to be right next to you for the Mountain West tournament. And Evan with us, and our producer, Jonathan Siegel, director Andy Goldberg, our entire crew. So tied at four early, and all 4 points for the Rebels from DJ Thomas. And he'll shoot two here. Let's check in with Evan.
Yeah, Andrew, DJ, also D-Don Thomas Jr. He was born to wear a Running Rebels uniform. That's his dad, D-Don Thomas Sr., played for UNLV in the early 90s. And talking to DJ yesterday, he said, this is surreal to be in this tournament at the Thomas and Mack. He's been coming to games here with his dad, with his family, growing up in Las Vegas. His favorite memory, not necessarily with UNLV, that's Sam Merrill game winner against San Diego State, where one Andrew Catalan was on the call.
We were on that one. That was in 2020. What a shot that was. And Merrill playing well in the NBA now. What a story that has been.
I remember where that shot happened too, right across the court.
Well, Boone, Caleb Boone, has gone back to the bench for UNLV. So a quick little spur just to see how it would react. And he's at the end of the bench trying to stretch out that right ankle.
You know, UNLV, they're kind of in now or never mode. You know, it's not like they're not going to have a game next week unless they win this tournament.
Substitutions for both teams, including Reese Waters on the floor. And that shot by Butler goes out of bounds.
I'm a big fan of this kid who's just coming in the game now.
Elijah Saunders.
Big fan. Big, strong body. He can shoot it. He is the second best shooter on the team, and Michael Waters is now in, who's a transfer from USC. He's probably the best shooter on the team, even though he hasn't shot it well in Mountain West games.
Saunders is 7 for 13 from deep over his last two games.
I'm a fan of his. I think he's going to be a very good player. Reese Waters, he was the sixth man of the year in the Pac-12 last year.
Coming over from USC. Here is Rob Whaley, draws the double, gets rid of it.
Great pass.
Rodriguez for three. Won't go in the rebound, Ledee.
That's not his strength. He's a 30% three-point shooter. That was a great pass by Whaley.
Ledee spinning in the paint. High arcing shot is good.
See, you know what makes these, we saw Alsamore, now we're seeing Ledee. You know what makes both those guys so good? Obviously, they're big and strong. They can put the ball on the floor. That's what makes them dangerous. They don't have to catch it in the post. They can make something happen on their own.
Here's Keelan Boone. His three won't go, and a rebound grab by Butler.
He's been a better shooter when he was at Pacific. Not shooting it great this year.
And a foul is called on Rodriguez.
You watch Jaden Ledee here. Look at the ball handling ability by the big kid. So he catches the ball at the three-point line, and he's able to create something. So you don't have to just throw it to him in the post. He can catch it on the perimeter and take it to the basket on his own.
Here's Saunders, and his shot attempt won't go. Boone the rebound.
Oh,
dangerous pass, but Boone collects. Back out to Thomas. Noel is back on the floor for the running Rebels.
They're not gonna guard Noel probably. They're gonna give a lot of help off of him. He's only made two threes all year.
Whaley, tough shot inside. Boone the rebound, put back no. And then a rebound for Miles Heidi of the Aztecs. Butler!
Doesn't it feel to you like Lamont Butler's been here forever?
Yes. A senior. Of course, the heroic shot in the national semifinals a year ago.
See, right now, they're letting this game get physical, and that really helps San Diego State. And you see Kevin Kruger not happy. Kevin Kruger thought there was a foul here on Keelan Boone. Well, here's Lamont Butler finishing strong. He made a pretty big shot for them last year.
No doubt about it. Meanwhile, Kruger's Rebels have missed their last six shot attempts.
You know what? You hear that a lot when somebody plays San Diego State.
No doubt.
They go on these 3-5 minute droughts.
It's tough to get a gauge so far, the split in the fans between UNLV and San Diego State. Aztecs always travel well, and UNLV students are on spring break, and they're all wearing red, so it's a little confusing. Thomas looking for a foul, and he gets one. And Brian Dutcher does not agree. Heidi commits the foul.
TJ Thomas here. Well, I think he got him on the arm. You know how you know you're getting old? When a guy who played for your son is now in games that I'm doing. Miles Byrd is in the game for San Diego State. I coached his dad at Villanova, my first team in 1992.
There he is on the right side of the bench.
There he is sitting there on the right. He was a McDonald's All-American, really good player and a great kid. And now I get to see his son, Miles.
How does that make you feel?
Old.
Calvin did play professionally as well, and this year was an assistant at Pacific.
Yeah, he's been in basketball a long time.
Darion Trammell brings the ball to floor for San Diego State.
And I think Miles is going to be a good player. He's in that rotation with these guys all year.
Three ball on the way, and it won't go for Waters, and the rebound to UNLV. Thomas right through the lane, and no good, and a foul is called. And DJ Thomas gets a little help up from his teammate.
So how many times have we seen this from San Diego State? They're 4 for 17 from the field, and they're up one. You know what I mean? We see this like
see
for
20
years.
Yeah.
You know, Steve Fisher started it, and it's like, you know, the Four Tops had a song. It's the same old song. Well, with them, it's the same old song.
You're right.
It's unbelievable.
They only give up 66 points per game. That's number one in the Mountain West. Both teams coming in with different trajectories over the second half of the season, though. The Aztecs finished 4-4 over the last eight games. They lost their last two of the regular season. Meanwhile, UNLV won 10 of 12 to close out the regular season.
You know, they've been a different team since they got Keelan Boone eligible. You know, they lost to Florida State early. They lost Loyola Marymount early. They lost to St. Mary's in overtime without Keelan Boone. They've been a different team since. The only blemishes, they lost to Air Force bad here. That was a bad loss.
Boone became eligible in the middle of December after he transferred for the second time, and the putback is good by Ladine.
Yeah, he just out-muscled Keelan Boone there underneath the basket.
DJ Thomas has gone to the bench. He scored all 8 points for the Running Rebels until now, as Justin Webster connects on a three.
He is a capable three-point shooter. If they can get him to knock down some threes, that is really going to make a big difference. Because you notice after DJ Thomas made those two drives, nobody's been able to get to the basket much.
Trammell bounces one to Ladine, a tie up inside, but no, a foul is called. So UNLV whistled for the foul, and we've got a timeout. Well, we told you it would be a defensive battle. So far it is. You're watching Bracket Week presented by Kubota. We are back with our keys to the game brought to you by Ace, the helpful place.
Well, for San Diego State, offensive rebound, they started out pretty good. They have four already in this game. Defensive pressure, that's kind of who they are. Try to force some turnovers to get some easy baskets. UNLV, push the tempo. You can't set up against this team for 40 minutes. I've seen them enough to know that. And you got to control the D. You can't have a 25-point game. You got to keep him down and hope that they're not making shots. Then you got a chance.
A moment ago, Evan with Kevin Krueger.
Well, Coach, we know scoring against San Diego State, always a challenge. What's the best way for you guys to attack them?
We just got to keep putting our head downhill, you know, and keep getting downhill and keep being tough. Anytime you dribble the third time against them, it's really tough. So we got to make every dribble count and try to create for each other.
What'd you see from Caleb Boone when he gave it a go?
He tried. He's worked incredibly hard for 3 days. Just notice him hobbling a little bit. It's just tough. In a game like this, you'd love to see if he could kind of get in a rhythm, but at the same time, they're so good that, you know, you'd hate for him to struggle a little bit and not be able to kind of get in a flow.
Coach, thank you.
Thank you.
That's a tough one. It's a different scenario than a regular season game, obviously, as Saunders misses the three. You'd love to give Caleb a little time to get in the flow of the game, but at the same time, you got to win this game.
Yeah, it's a tough way to go. There's no doubt. Obviously, Coach Krueger saw something that he didn't think was great, so he just took him out.
Webster again, another three, his second.
You know, both these teams, neither team is a great three-point shooting team. They only average about 6.5 to 7 threes a game, so not a big part of either arsenal.
Saunders cross court to Bird, baseline high arcing shot, no, and tipped out of bounds. It'll be UNLV basketball. Second three for Webster.
And that was not a good switch there. Trammell didn't come over fast enough.
Some chance of Rebels from the hometown fans. Kevin Krueger said, look, yes, we're at home, but it doesn't feel like a true home game. The locker rooms are different. The pregame intros are different. Now he doesn't get to sleep in his own bed. They it's as close to home as you can get.
Ask those other coaches what they think.
Reese Waters commits his second foul. So he's coming out of the game.
Now, in the Mountain West defense, this is a great place to have this tournament.
No doubt.
You know, so everybody's got to be quiet. You know, you have it here. People come to Las Vegas. It's a great crowd we got today.
And by the way, UNLV hasn't been to the semifinals in 10 years. So it's not like they're playing at home and beating everybody. They're not.
And you know what? It's kind of similar to the Big East. As Big East coaches don't like being, they like being at the Garden, but they feel like it helps St. John. But St. John has done much in Madison Square Garden for a long time.
They actually today finally got back to the semifinals for the first time in ages.
Yeah, ages.
Shot clock at 9. With 9:47 on the clock, there you see UNLV. 8 straight losses in the Mountain West Tournament quarterfinals.
And here's what here's another thing that San Diego State does. They've taken 8 more shots than UNLV already. Between second shots and turnovers and offensive rebound, that's what they do. But UNLV doing a good job.
Thomas, 3 with the shot clock expiring, and Trammell wants to race the other way. Trammell end-to-end, and he missed it. Scramble for it. Who's got it? And it looks like Noel was out of bounds. It'll be San Diego State basketball.
You know, that's the other thing about Jaden Ledee. I mean, he plays hard. He ran the floor so hard when Trammell was pushing that.
His foot was out of bounds. That
clearly.
Oh, wow.
Oh, they're going to look at that, I think.
Ledee and Whaley are really tangled up inside. And that foul goes on Whaley as first.
No, they don't feel like the need to look at it. Ledee's one of those guys, too. He can foul out the whole team.
He'll take a jumper here. And the rebound to Rodriguez.
If you're UNLV, that's what you want him to do. Do that. We won't foul you. If you make it, you make it.
Thomas pulls it out. Now he'll take a deep three. No good. Butler tips it to Ledee. 4 straight misses now for the Aztecs on this end of the floor. Let's see if they can get something going. They trail by 4. Parrish in the paint for 2. Too strong. And the rebound to Ledee. Trying to go right back up. And we have a tie-up.
Wow.
Possession arrow will keep the ball with the Aztecs. Well, tomorrow, 5 Eastern, get ready for some tournament action as bracket week continues from Cleveland. Kent State and Bowling Green. After Kent State beat Toledo earlier today, we'll meet in 1 semi, and then Akron will take on the winner of Ohio and Western Michigan. That's all tomorrow on CBS Sports Network. As Whaley, a little shaken up over on the bench. Parrish, 3 ball, no.
San Diego State 5-for-24 from the field, 0-for-6 from 3.
Carl Jones back on the floor, replacing Justin Webster.
See, give UNLV credit. They only have 2 turnovers so far, which means that San Diego State can't, is not making steals and getting out of it, but he does that.
Ledee's got 8 points. Here's Boone for 3. And a big rebound by Carl Jones.
That is a big rebound. He played very well the last time they played San Diego State.
Senior from Chicago. Now a freshman, Thomas. Oh, that's pretty. Wow. Woo. DJ Thomas.
Talk about a stop and go.
Thomas already in double figures with 10. Oh. Maybe got away with the travel.
Yes.
Jones all over with D. Shot clock in 5. Where will Trammell go? He turns it over. Rodriguez breaks free the other way. Rodriguez lost it. And it will be San Diego State ball when we come back. Back and forth we go with 7:08 to go in the first half. Ladee already with 8 points, but DJ Thomas with 10 for the Rebels.
Back to Las Vegas, Coach Dedon Thomas Jr. with 10 points early in this game. How do you better control him?
We've tried a couple of things. We're switching ball screens. We're trying to double him. You know, we got to keep him off balance, switch up our coverages. He's a wonderful player.
In these type of games, what creates separation?
Got to get a run. Offensive rebound, fast break basket, something that gives you a little momentum.
Coach, appreciate you.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's always a big thing for San Diego State because they've always been a little offensively challenged in the half court. Getting some easy baskets definitely help.
Here's the defense for San Diego State.
Yeah, you know, you stop your dribble there, you're just asking for a double team to come, and that's what these guys thrive on. Now, UNLV only has 2 turnovers in the game, and that's one of them.
San Diego State is 6 of 25 from the floor. And UNLV 5 for 15. The offensive rebounds have been huge for the Aztecs, as we talked about. 9 for San Diego State on the offensive glass to just 2 for UNLV, and a whistle inside. That's going to go on Carl Jones.
And the thing about San Diego State is they play so well in these ugly games. I mean, here they can't make a basket. They're down 4. You know, with 7 minutes to go. Some other team might be down 15 in this stage with the way they're shooting the ball, but they're not.
Butler spins out of bounds, and it's UNLV ball.
Pretty good job here by Carl Jones coming over. He's been very active in this game.
Second season for Jones at UNLV, and he heads to the bench with Whaley back in. Great defense here for San Diego State. Shot clock down to 5.
Yeah, right now UNLV can't penetrate to the basket at all.
Boone lost it. They don't even get a shot off. How about the Aztecs?
They caused more shot violations.
.620 to go. Still a 4-point game. Aztecs have missed 7 of their last 8 shots. Ladee is battling Whaley down low. Butler comes to get it. Butler inside. Powell takes a bump and scores.
Pretty good pass there. San Diego State hurt UNLV in that last game with the pressure. They're not really pressuring them as much in the backcourt.
Whoa. Thomas doesn't get this one to drop, and Powell pushes up ahead. Powell, left alone, does not take the 3.
They're going to bring the double on the bounce.
Ladee, tough turnaround. No. And bodies colliding in the paint.
Those are the kind of shots you want Ladee to take. Fadeaways, you don't have to foul them. They're tough shots.
Micah Parrish called for the foul. Werner Ladder is the proud title sponsor of the Naismith Coach of the Year Award. Join us over Final Four weekend as we highlight this year's winners right here on CBS Sports Network.
I'll tell you, Danny Sprinkle's up for National Coach of the Year. He's going to get some votes for that, for what he did with no one coming back and winning the Mountain West.
Sprinkle and the Aggies had to go to overtime earlier today to beat Fresno State. They'll take on the winner of this one here. Rodriguez bounces it to Boone. Missed it.
Well, when you get those chances against San Diego State, you have to convert. You don't get them too often.
Parrish muscling his way down low and a tie-up. Good defense by DJ Thomas. And this time it's UNLV basketball.
DJ Thomas doesn't play like a guy who is a high school senior. Should be a high school senior.
He's only 18 years old, reclassified to join the team this season. And there was many factors that went into that decision, but as Kevin Kruger told us this week, we needed a point guard. There was an immediate need for him to play, and he's averaged a team high 34 minutes a game.
And I'll tell you what I'm seeing about him, he's bigger than I thought he was. I know he's listed at 6'1", just seems a little bit bigger.
Whaley brings it across.
Yeah, Butler denying the ball to Thomas.
Whaley's going to go all the way, and he draws the foul. Well, that's a great matchup to watch. I mean, Lamont Butler, an elite non-ball defender, all over DJ Thomas on that last set as Heidi picks up his second.
Yeah, he couldn't even touch the ball there.
Here's Rob Whaley at the free throw line. Junior from Farmington, Utah, as we send it over to Evan.
Yeah, and we were talking to DJ about the physicality of this game, having faced San Diego State earlier this season. He said they're always bumping you every chance they get, always making sure you feel them. But he feels like he's built for this, going back to his dad, again, a former player. He used to have those pads out when they'd be getting workouts in. He built them for games like this, guys.
You know, I remember when we used to play Georgetown, when Big John Thompson was the coach. They would press you. They foul you like every play. And I would tell the refs before the game, listen, they're going to foul us 500 times. You only have to call, just call 25 for me, all right? Not 500. You don't have to call 500. Call 25.
Reese Waters, and that's pretty to tie it at 16. Webster's third triple of the half.
This guy has really made it. When you only have 19 in the game and you got three threes.
Webster's 3-for-3 from deep. The rest of the Rebels are combined 0-for-6. 3.5 to go. Nearly a turnover. Saunders left alone. Missed it.
And he's one of their better shooters at 36% for the season.
San Diego State 0-7 from deep and a foul inside will send us to immediate timeout.
We got a battle going on here without a doubt. Two great defensive teams doing it at 1960.
You're watching Bracket Week presented by Kubota. Rebels up by three. Reminder coming up 18T at the half. Adam Zucker, Roy Hibbert, Shelvin Mack, and Gary Parrish break down our first half and highlights of all the conference tournament action. It's all coming up on 18T at the half as we take a look at some of the results from bubble teams today and what sticks out to you, Lap.
Well, St. John's beating Seton Hall. I think St. John's is definitely in the tournament. I still believe Seton Hall's in. That was a huge win for Pitt beating Wake Forest. Wake Forest in big trouble right now. They had a late season swoon. I thought Michigan State was in good shape before that game to be like a 9-10 seed. And Mississippi State, big one they needed to win against a team that hadn't had a good year this year, LSU.
Second game of the day here in Vegas. Earlier today, you saw Utah State in overtime defeat Fresno State. And as we said at the end of that game, it is official now. Justin Hudson, the Fresno State coach, in his press conference after the game, said he is done at Fresno State. So they'll be looking for a new head coach. 3 minutes to go in the first half here. Winner of our game will see Utah State in the first semifinal tomorrow night. Waters, no good. And the rebound is grabbed by Webster, who's had a very nice first half with 9 points.
And 0-for-7 for San Diego State from three.
Webster looking for more, and he draws the foul.
Webster being very aggressive. He turned the corner really hard there and drew that foul.
Ladee commits his first. Webster, a 90% free throw shooter, that's tops on the team. Team up, hang on, take the ride. PBR teams coming this July. Webster in double figures for the ninth time this year. He's got 11. His season high is 16. And he wants to be a sports broadcaster, Lap. So when he's done playing,
hey, he's going to be play-by-play if he wants to be.
You don't know that. He could be an analyst. He's playing. Ladee trying to spin free, and a foul is called on Whaley.
That's Whaley's second. And the problem when you're guarding a guy like Ladee, they can pile up very quickly.
So Carl Jones goes to the scores table. He'll come back in for UNLV.
And Keelan Boone is telling Whaley, just get your arms straight up in the air. Don't come over. Straight up.
Aztecs have had a rough shooting first half, 26%. They've missed three of their last four, and now the Rebels on a 6-0 run.
Now here comes the full court pressure. Again, Lamar Butler really trying to keep the ball out of Thomas's hands.
Thomas trying to go to work on Saunders, gets by him. This step back high arcing jumper is no good. Rodriguez cleans it up inside and draws the foul. With 1:56 to play. Ladee picks up his second.
Well, he's got to, he needs to come out now. 2 minutes to go. And you know, the way Ladee plays on offense, he can easily pick up an offensive foul.
So Ladee goes out and Miles Heidi comes back in. Heidi is playing with three fouls. Freshman from North Bend, Washington. Rebels up a touchdown. Chanel trying to get unlocked. Cannot. And Keelan Boone the rebound.
They are really struggling to score. I've seen San Diego State over the years struggle to score, but they are really struggling. But give UNLV credit.
from the outside. It's a 10-point UNLV lead. I mean,
those four threes that UNLV hold.
Oh, collision as Thomas hits the deck hard. A timeout called by San Diego State with 1:12 to go. Aztecs trouble scoring, and the Rebels are taking advantage. The Conference USA Men's Tournament is underway, and you'll see the semifinals tomorrow on CBS Sports Network. The top seed Sam Houston advancing, and Louisiana Tech, the number two seed, losing to Middle Tennessee. Semifinals tomorrow on CBS Sports Network. So San Diego State is shooting 25% and 0 of 7 from deep. And the fewest points they've scored in a first half this year is 26. That was against Utah State. Might not get there.
No, and they're playing a team that is really hot on the defensive end. I mean, you look at this UNLV team, they won 10 of their last 12, and it's because of the defense that they played.
An 11-1 run. Butler, good shot fake and a foul. Keelan Boone commits the foul, his first for UNLV. It'll be two shots for Lamont Butler. Earlier this week, named the Mountain West Defensive Player of the Year.
And to show what kind of respect they have for his defense, he didn't even lead the league in steals. He was third in steals, yet he was a Defensive Player of the Year. You usually don't see that in a guard.
Clap, you've said it throughout this half, and we've said it a number of times doing the Aztecs. The offense always kind of comes along slowly. It's the defense that's there. But how concerning is this first half offensive output for San Diego State?
It's really concerning because you are not able to turn UNLV over. And that's, you know, Thomas, DJ Thomas has been really good in this game. When he hasn't been scoring, he's really been controlling the game for UNLV. They're not coughing the ball up. And so San Diego State's got to score in a half court. It's not their strength.
So many times you see them struggling offensively, but you just know they're going to be there at the end. I don't know if you have that feeling right now.
And they're, you know, UNLV's done a better job on the defensive glass lately, so they're not even getting anything easy on offensive rebounds with as many shots as they've missed.
Boone, deep three. Whoa. And a rebound to Heidi with a 1 second difference between the game clock and the shot clock. Butler with five to Parrish. Parrish, step back three. No good. And a shot clock violation. San Diego State is now 0 of 8 from the outside.
And you know what the other problem is? They don't have any. Trammell or Butler's not really even penetrating to create something off the dribble in the lane. Ladie is out now. They're not making a three, so when Ladie does come back in, they can pack it in on him.
Parrish 0 for 5. Trammell 0 for 4. Saunders 0 for 3 as UNLV calls timeout to draw something up with 1.6 to go in the first half. Rebels by 8 with the ball and 1.6 on the clock.
They're going to try, obviously, a touchdown pass. They got to get this ball minimum to half court. Throw a heave.
It'll be Keelan Boone to inbound.
I'm not a big fan of not having anybody on the ball in that situation.
Boone.
Oh, this
throws
is
it right to Trammell for three! My goodness!
Let me tell you something, Andrew. and I know I'm saying it after the fact, my entire coaching career, with 1 second to go, we went the length, I would just throw it inbounds to my guy and let the buzzer sound, and that's it, especially if I'm up. I would not have done that.
First three of the game for San Diego State. What a nightmare finish for Kevin Kruger and the Rebels, and Kevin is with Evan.
When you have so much momentum and a half ends like that, what's the message to the guys?
Oh, he's got to brush it off. I mean, and get ready to come out, have a good warm-up, get ready for another 20 minutes. If that shot goes in or not, it's going to be another 20 minutes of fighting and another 20-minute battle. So either way, you got to come out ready for a good start in the second half.
What's worked defensively to hold them in check, obviously, for much of that first half?
I thought we've done a really good job of just kind of playing for each other, boxing out as good as we can, and trusting that teammates will come in and help rebound and just help make it a full team effort.
Coach, thank you.
Thank you.
Well, credit to Kevin, because that is not an easy way to end the first half. 27-22 at the break. We'll get you to Adam Zucker in our New York studio for AT&T at the half, coming up after this.
College basketball on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by PBR Teams. Team up, hang on, take the ride. PBR Teams, July 2024.
Deep in the Nevada desert, if you look closely, you can see Leslie Chow as we see the first half numbers, and that only three-pointer by the Aztecs came at the buzzer after that giveaway by UNLV. That courtside with Steve Lapis, I'm Andrew Catalan. We'll hear from Evan Washburn coming up. So much on the line for UNLV in this game. They are not projected to be in the tournament field right now, but they're one of the hottest teams, and if they win the Mountain West, they'd be the seventh in for this league.
Yeah, I mean, let's face it, too, this is their home building, and right now they played a great half. It was a shame the way it ended for them to give up that three, but their three-point shooting has been a key, especially when you talk about Justin Webster and what he did coming off the bench by scoring 11 points. But you'll see here, they've done a good job. Webster comes off that screen ready to shoot. They don't get to him at all. And then you have DJ Thomas here looking to draw and kick. Keelan Boone knocks that one down.
Let's check in with Evan.
Spoke to Brian Dutcher with a smile on his face. He said, when you shoot 27%, you should be down 27. But obviously credited his defense and the fact this is only a five-point game. Said they have to try and manufacture some offense in the second half. That looks like getting points in transition, fast breaks, and they're going to keep shooting threes, guys. They made 11 the last time these two teams played on this floor, and obviously it wasn't the case in the first half.
And a good start for the Aztecs with Ladine.
And now all of a sudden, you know, UNLV should have been up 8 at halftime. Now all of a sudden it's a three-point game.
Ladine in double figures. He's got 11 points. Whaley, tough, and he draws the foul. That's going to go on Lamont Butler. First foul, the Mountain West Defensive Player of the Year.
I don't know if I've seen a team over the years, Andrew, that wins more games shooting under 40% than San Diego State. I've seen it a ton of times myself, where they shoot 35%, 32%. When Steve Fisher was there, they won a game where they shot the 20s.
Whaley rattles that one in. As we told you off the top, in Mountain West Conference tournament play, UNLV has lost 8 in a row against San Diego State. Powell, triple, yes. Just his 10th three-pointer of the year. And then after the play, an injured Rebel. That's Whaley, who is hobbling and in some pain.
Oh, they can't lose him. He's hobbling.
Needs help coming off the floor. Keelan Boone has got his arm around him. Another look. who, and it looks like Ladie just kind of collided with him. You can see Ladie look back, and you heard Whaley shout in pain. Carl Jones comes on the floor to replace Whaley, but if you're just joining us, Caleb Boone rolled his ankle on Saturday, played for a couple of minutes early, but Kevin Kruger told Evan Washburn in an interview during the first half that he didn't like what he saw, so he has not come back in. So shorthanded today, and Thomas, oh wow, how is that San Diego State ball?
I think he said he was on the line.
He's saying that Trammell knocked it out of bounds. San Diego State fans don't like that call, but it is UNLV basketball.
And here comes the pressure.
Thomas up the floor. Thomas all the way. Gets it to go.
You know, to be coming full speed and be able to make a nice soft touch like that is really hard to do.
A dozen for DJ. Ladie doubled inside, and a tie-up. It'll be UNLV basketball. Good defense by the Rebels. Jones and Noel converging on Ladie.
I know Whaley's back there trying to walk it off, but
definitely can hear the Aztec fans now. It's tough to tell early on the split, but as usual, San Diego State has brought a lot.
They travel.
Boone thought about a three, drives right in. Boone hangs and can't finish. Mel will tend to shoot. Passes it to Ladie, defended by Jones. Ladie over Jones.
You know, like I said before, that's the shot you want to see him take. If he takes that and he makes it, he makes it. You'd rather him do that than drive to the basket and Whaley's coming back in.
Good to see Whaley at the scorer's table. Thomas. Boone for three.
Tough shot.
It's good. Keelan Boone.
Wow. Not an easy shot. Well contested, but you know, his size obviously really helped.
Boone had started 1 of 8 from the floor before that three.
I mean, you see Keelan Boone here just shoots it over Trammell, so the difference in height was really the difference in him getting that one off.
Over to Evan.
Yeah, you guys pointed out Rob Whaley Jr. checking back in this game. The left leg and ankle is the area of concern as he was rolled up on. No added tape or support for that leg. Obviously a little discomfort, but fighting through.
And Ladie fights through for two more. He's got 15.
Yeah, he's really starting now to find his way down there.
Aztecs have started this half 4 out of 4 from the floor. Rodriguez, oh, what a spin move, but he missed it.
He's got to finish that.
And he knows it, claps his hand as he trots back on defense. And now a whistle and a foul. Keelan Boone commits his second.
Yeah, they need Rodriguez to score. This is a great spin move.
Chance of Let's Go Aztecs here at the Thomas and Mack Center. Tough shot there. Long rebound is grabbed by Parrish. Up ahead, Trammell.
It's backcourt.
And a backcourt violation. Yeah. 8 turnovers by San Diego State, 6 for UNLV. Justin Webster is back on the floor for the Rebels. He had 11 points in the first half. Whaley trying to spin on the D. Now on the perimeter, it's Thomas. A talented freshman around Powell all the way, but doesn't get it to drop. UNLV this half is 2 for 6.
They just have to make sure they continue to guard. Tough shot.
Trebell knocks it down.
Ryan Dutcher said it. They're going to start making shots. They have.
Tied at 34.
Great pass.
Webster in the corner with 4 on the shot clock and a foul with 3 to shoot.
And San Diego State did a great job recovering there. We got a tie ball game, 34 all in the Mountain West.
They don't have the scores on the floor. It's Butler with 2 seconds. He's got to put it up.
Jim Nance on the call last year for San Diego State. Lamont Butler beating FAU in the semis. Don't miss the NCAA Men's Basketball Championship Selection Show this Sunday, 6 Eastern on CBS and streaming on Paramount Plus. See what drama lies ahead this year and potential bid stealers. Here's a good list, including UNLV.
Yeah, that is a good list. You know, St. Joe's won today, too, again. So they beat Richmond, who was the top seed in the Atlantic 10. So they're also up there as a possible bid stealer. Because Dayton is the one team from that league that is definitely in. If they don't win the tournament, that's going to be an extra bid going to the A-10.
Whaley to the ground again. Thomas. Caught up on the baseline, the D rips it away.
Good job, the D blindsided him.
Butler, you just saw his heroic shot. How about this one?
That is a strong move with the left hand.
And San Diego State has the lead. First lead since early in the first half when it was 10-8.
Yeah, UNLV now struggling to score, which happens all the time against San Diego State. But San Diego State has picked it up on offense, and there's another steal.
Trammell up ahead to Powell.
New timeout.
It's a 9-0 run for the Aztecs. And Kevin Krueger calls timeout for the Runnin' Rebels.
College basketball on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by Ace, the helpful place.
This was the scene last night. The UNLV women win their third straight Mountain West tournament title. They beat San Diego State 66-49. So another great season for the Runnin' Rebels. The women, the Lady Rebels, as CBS Sports proudly celebrates Women's History Month. See if it could be a double dose of victory for UNLV against San Diego State. But right now, the Aztecs on a 9-0 run.
You know, the big problem for UNLV, Andrew, is only five Rebels have scored in this game. Only 3 have baskets. So only 3 guys from UNLV have made a basket in this game. That's the problem. And San Diego State really starting to pick it up now.
Let's check in with Evan.
And guys, the message in that UNLV huddle was poise, kind of letting the guys know, hey, each side's going to go on runs here. 3 turnovers early in this second half for the Runnin' Rebels. Again, poise was the message.
Evan, based on what you saw at practice yesterday and again the warm-ups today, do you think there's any chance Caleb Boone comes back in?
You never want to say never, Andrew, but I would say very slim, and whatever he would bring to this game, I don't think would bode well in this style of game.
Yeah, good point. As Thomas comes up short on the jumper and Ladie comes the other way.
Yeah, right now they need somebody who's going to score a basket, Andrew, and I think that's not one of his real strengths anyway, and then with that one leg, tough. That's the problem for UNLV now. They don't know, they can't score.
Trammell, his turn three. Trammell was 3 of his last 19 on three-pointers entering today. He's 3 for 3 this afternoon as a foul is called. I mean, I hate to bring it up, but you look back at that last play of the first half and how this game has changed since then.
I mean, it gave San Diego State a little leap, and they came out here with it, and that was a big play. There's no doubt. They should have gone into the locker room up 8.
Totally different feel if you're San Diego State going into the locker room down 8. As Whaley commits his third foul, and Kevin Kruger does not like it.
13 fouls.
Twelve consecutive points for San Diego State.
UNLV trying a little zone. That's a good move by Kevin Kruger. It was time to change up something.
Harris can't get it to drop. And Powell, the offensive rebound right to Webster.
The hard thing about playing zone against San Diego State, it's hard to rebound out of that zone. But I think they needed to change something.
DJ Thomas directing traffic. Boone, that's a deep three, and he's fouled. Powell commits the foul. It'll be 3 free throws for Keelan Boone.
That's a really bad foul because, let's face it, UNLV is reeling on the offensive end, and to just let him get to the foul line now. Couldn't really tell from that.
Rebels have not scored in the last 4 minutes and 9 seconds. And Boone makes the free throw. Keelan Boone named the third team All Mountain West earlier this week in his first year at UNLV. Last year at Pacific in his first 3 years with Oklahoma State.
I tell you, Andrew, they could use Webster to do a little bit of what he did in the first half.
And Boone makes all 3. 4-point game.
Now UNLV in a 1-3-1 defense, and with Keelan Boone on top, he's long. He can make it really hard up there to reverse the ball.
Tough catch by Ladie, and a blocking foul is called. That's going to be on Shane Noel, his second. Each team with 4 team fouls here in the second half. Trammell, corner 3. Not this time, but he follows his shot. Passes to Ladie, who draws the foul. Great hustle by Darion Trammell.
Yeah, he just beat everybody to that rebound.
As Keelan Boone commits his third. You think about all the great players who have played at San Diego State. They have not had a player average 20 points per game for a season since the mid-80s when Anthony Watson averaged 22.5 points per game. Entering today, Jaden Ledee averaging 20.5 points per game.
And Andrew, that's in the days when San Diego State was bad. Before, way before Steve Fisher got there.
He's got 15 so far today.
Those are two big misses for UNLV. That helps him.
Webster follows his miss, and Rodriguez had it but lost it.
Rodriguez is really hurting him today because he's a good player and he's just not playing good.
Ledee all the way, no call, a lot of contact, and now a foul. And if that's on Keelan Boone, that'll be his fourth.
Wow.
And it is.
Oh, wow. Yeah, that's a foul, there's no doubt.
Well, it looks like they may have changed a foul. There is a discrepancy. The official score sheet says three on Boone, but Kevin Kruger was just looking at the scorer's table for clarification. Boone stays out there, and Ledee is fouled again.
Well, I'm guessing he's got three because he's still in the game.
Well, there's no way they would have kept him in.
No, not in a four-point game. Not in a four-point game. If they were down 8 or 10, he might just roll the dice, but not in a four-point game.
All right, so we're being told Noel has four and Keelan Boone has three. And Ledee misses another. So Noel with four fouls comes out.
I mean, the free throws have been a big story in this game. You got San Diego State 3 for 7 right now. You got UNLV 14 for 19, though they haven't gotten to the line much in the second half.
Ledee makes that one, and he's going to get a breather here as Miles Heide returns.
Get him out to the under 12. Oh, he threw it off Sauce's back. Rodriguez averaged 11 points a game. They need him to start playing. He's got 2 points in this game.
Turnover by the running Rebels. And San Diego State hands it right back. 11:58 to go. Aztecs have flipped the script here in the second half, but still a tight one. A 5-point game. You're watching Bracket Week, presented by Kubota. ...42-37 in favor of San Diego State as we revisit the keys to the game, which are brought to you by Ace, the helpful place.
Well, offensive rebound for San Diego State. They have been getting on the offensive glass pretty hard. Defensive pressure, forced 11 turnovers in this game and 14 points off of that. Pretty good. UNLV pushed the tempo. Haven't really been able to do that much, especially here in the second half. And control the D. You know, they've done a decent job. They just have been fouling him a lot lately, which is kind of par for the course with him, but he's 7 for 13 from the field, so they've done a decent job of making it hard for him.
You look at the second half shooting, San Diego State 8 for 12, while UNLV is just 2 for 8.
And really, DJ Thomas has not been able to find any openings.
Looking for one here. Down. He gets it and finishes. 14 for Thomas. A one possession game. And Ledee quickly back at the scorer's table. Aztecs working around. Saunders shot fake to the corner and Waters. Waters on the baseline. Hangs, misses, out of bounds. It'll stay with the Aztecs.
That was a pretty good defensive set by UNLV because it looked like they were going to get an open shot, but they kept closing out hard defensively.
Jackie Johnson has entered for UNLV, the transfer from Duquesne. Shot clock is at 6. It'll be Butler to inbound.
Oh, so Ladie,
great job. Oh, the rejection by Boone. Ladie gets it back in a foul. The 12th foul that Ladie has drawn today.
That was a great up screen for Ladie on this out of bounds play. That's what got him open the first time, which created the problem. Really made a good block.
Third foul on Rodriguez. Well, Jerry Palm has 6 Mountain West teams in the NCAA tournament. New Mexico, his last 4 in. The 6 teams would be a Mountain West conference record. And a big one for New Mexico tonight as they take on Boise State in the late quarterfinal game.
I mean, if they lose, it won't be a bad loss, but they're not going to sleep Saturday night. If they win, they'll sleep well.
They wouldn't do Pitino against Pitino in Dayton, would they?
You don't think? That would be terrible. I mean, for both of them,
that
would
family.
Be brutal.
Yeah, that would be rough. Reese Waters commits his 3rd foul. 5 team fouls against the Aztecs.
That's a foul. Ladie is bumping him. I tell you, Whaley has not been able to do anything offensively.
He's 0 for 4. Saunders catch and shoot 3. And a lot of bodies collide inside. Foul is called. The 14th foul in less than 10 minutes here in the second half.
Ladie is so strong, and when he plants himself in that lane, it's tough. What are they going to look at something?
Yeah, they are going to go to the monitor. Don't know who the foul was called on. All they said is that the previous play is under review. Whaley and Ladie were tangled up.
Was there any call on the court?
One of the officials definitely had a call.
There's a common foul on the floor. We're looking for a possible flagrant foul.
We just don't know who the common foul was called against.
Right.
Is that a hook and hold inside?
You know what? It was a hook, but it seemed like it was gone. Right now, there it is. It might be a hook
might
and
be.
Hold. Yeah, that's going to be a flagrant one on Whaley. I think. And I'll tell you what, there used to be a lot of hook and holds. That's the first one I'm seeing this year. And obviously we've done a lot of games. That's the first one that we've seen. So they have gotten it out of the game. It's a dangerous play.
So we wait with 10:29 to go.
I think it's a flagrant one. You think?
Looks like we're still looking. Oh, we're about to get a conclusion. I do think it's a hook and hold. I do. Brian Dutcher, 20 wins every season as head coach at San Diego State, now in his 7th year.
Quarterfinal,
All right. Now they huddle up, still awaiting the call.
This is a long one, but
here we go.
They're coming over to us now.
The foul has been upgraded to a flagrant hook and hold foul on 24 White.
13's gonna shoot two. The ball's gonna end up being a black ball underneath here. 24.
So the foul is called on Jackie Johnson.
That's whose arm was in there?
And it is a flagrant.
I mean, I saw the hook and hold. Wait a minute, isn't that the hook and hold there? Oh, I see behind on the other side. There were two of them.
How about that?
Oh, yeah, double hook and hold.
So free throws coming for Ladie. We got that all sorted out now.
Well, we were looking at the big guys there. He got hooked from the back.
Ladie is 4 of 8 from the line so far today. The struggles continue. One more look on the right of your screen, 24.
Right there, and he pulls him down.
Yeah. It's a good call.
Could have called on either one of them, but yes, that one was 100%.
And because of the flagrant, it is San Diego State basketball as well. 45-39. Webster back on the floor for Johnson. Waters on the wing, double teamed. And an offensive foul is called on Reese Waters. And that's his fourth.
He's really been struggling.
He's 1 of 6 today and now has 4 fouls. We asked Brian Dutcher about Reese Waters this week, and he said, look, he's a dynamic scorer, but I haven't put him in the best positions to score. And because of that, he's been pressing at times. And he goes, that's on me. I got to get him in better positions. Has not been able to do that so far today.
No. Well, Lamont Butler took a shot here. Right there.
Ooh. It seems like there's been a foul on almost every possession here the last few minutes.
There have been a lot.
16 fouls in less than 10 minutes this half. Butler is trying to catch his breath over on the San Diego State bench after that shot he took. Webster with 13 today. Webster got a hand on that, but right to Ladie. Ladie will take that jumper and hits. He's got 21 points and 10 rebounds, his 12th double-double of the year.
And he's another guy that draws a million fouls.
Only had 2 double-doubles prior to this year. Boone's 3, no good. Ladie, another rebound.
Yeah, the problem for UNLV is where is some consistent offense?
Ladie for 3 is good. His 15th of the year.
He didn't have 1 in his career before this year. 15 this year.
0 for 16 prior to this year, and this year he's 15 for 37 with the answer from Thomas. And Kevin Kruger calls a quick timeout. With Thomas's father watching on, it's a 2-possession game.
Look at the D here. He shot a good percentage this year, too. He's shooting 36% from there, so it's not like he's... But then DJ Thomas They go underneath the screen. They basically dare him, and he's another guy, 36% three-point shooter.
So UNLV now with just one timeout remaining the rest of the way. See the time before ninth made field goal for the Aztecs in the first half, which was at the buzzer. And here it's taken half the amount of time in the second half. Ten to play. Saunders has not been able to find the touch today, but the offensive rebound to Parrish and a foul.
The offensive glass is really starting to hurt UNLV.
That's the fourth foul on Rob Whaley. 17 offensive rebounds today for the Aztecs, just 5 for the Running Rebels.
You know, I think Whaley, I'd probably take him out for a little bit, but, you know, that's what they're doing.
Carl Jones back. Well, we asked Brian Dutcher, what are the keys to the game against UNLV, and he said the number one key is rebounding, the number two key, rebounding, and the number three key is rebounding. They are plus 15 on the glass today.
Yeah, I mean, UNLV, especially with Boone not in the game. Oh, that's not a good spot.
Thomas in trouble, gets it to Jones, and a whistle, and a foul.
This is a really strong trap here. Look at that. You see how they get their feet together? They make it so that he can't split that.
But Parrish fouls, and now a 1-1 coming for Carl Jones, who's just 5 of 9 from the free throw line this year. Makes the front end. Played at Morgan Park High School in Chicago, won a state title as a junior. In his second season with UNLV. Butler coming back in. Good sign there for the Aztecs. One out of two for Jones. The D left open. You can't do that.
No, they're finding him all over the place now. He is camping out in the lane, posting up, making the face-up jumper.
A foul at midcourt committed by Miles Byrd.
That is a foul. Hit him with the body. Right here, you're going to see. I mean, that's a foul. His father used to foul, too. No, I'm only joking.
It's a 1-1 for Webster. This is the guy you want at the line for a 1-1. He's 90% on the year. And every foul the rest of the way will be 2 free throws. Oh, Webster, a rare miss.
And against this team, you need every point you can get. Here's the 1-3-1 again. That's where you got to get the ball. Good pass.
Three not there. Rebound the D. Another offensive rebound for the Aztecs.
Good pass.
And another foul is called.
The offensive rebounding has been a real problem. You know, as the game is going on, UNLV getting more and more fatigued, I think.
54-46. You're watching Bracket Week presented by Kubota. Nevada and Colorado State are in the building, and so is our producer, Steve McKee. Somehow is able to get through the tight security here at the Mountain West. So Steve McKee will produce. Rich Waltz will call the play-by-play. Dan Dickow will be the analyst, and Evan Washburn will be here right through the night. Coming up next, Nevada, Colorado State on CBS Sports Network, and then Boise State in New Mexico in the nightcap. All right, Evan, game number two for you. What do you got?
Yes, it's going to be a fun night, too. I was thinking about how this game, guys, embodies something Brian Dutcher told us this week about how with so much experience, some fifth-year guys, what they went through last year, there's this feeling like we can turn it on. Now, that's dangerous at times. You see that across sports. But this game does sort of show that example. First half what it was, and they've turned it on in the second. Now, can they continue that? Not just the end of this game, but maybe throughout this tournament.
Well, you know, that's a great point, Evan, because last week we were with Dusty May at FAU, and he said the same thing, that that's what happened to them at times this year. They felt like they could turn it on because of the experience they had getting to a Final Four.
UNLV only has four field goals here in the second half. They need offense, and they need it now. 7:50 to go.
Well, Andrew, they still only have three guys that have made a basket in this game.
Webster's rejected, then he goes to the ground hard, gets it over to Jones for the jam.
And here they are with that 1-3-1 again.
Trammell on the bench for San Diego State. Ladie has had the hot hand. Here he finds Powell for two.
What a great execution against the 1-3-1. They get the ball to the high post and get it down low.
Whaley at the scorer's table with four fouls. Thomas. And we have a foul.
Well, you take a look here how they beat that 1-3-1. The D's right here. He's going to flash into the middle, which is the important place to go. They get the ball there, and then Jay Powell cut into the basket. Webster comes late. Good job of executing against that 1-3-1. It just shows how important it is to get the ball into the foul line area against both zones.
Thomas at the line for two. Jones out, Whaley in with four. Caleb Boone has not come back in since the early test of that injured right ankle. Noel back in with four fouls. Chance of let's go Aztecs as they try to move on to the semifinals. Butler, great pass to Powell, but he missed it. Out of bounds though to San Diego State, as in the corner Thomas could not grab it.
That was a great pass from the top, from one side to the other. Well, Butler does a great job of getting two guys to play him. And that's a key in playing against his own also, to get two guys to play you, so that way you're 4-on-3 against the other guys.
A block for Keelan Boone, his second. 10 to shoot. Bird, that's a deep three. It's good! Miles Bird from downtown. Deep. Noel. Good defense by the Aztecs. It'll stay with UNLV, but what a job inside by San Diego State.
Yeah, they left Miles Byrd just out here, way open. Obviously, it was very deep.
And then Byrd gets credit with a block on the other end, his second. Trammell back in as Butler heads out. Thomas, 17-footer, is pure.
He comes off that screen and stops on a dime.
21 for Thomas, his career high is 25 at New Mexico. And a rejection by Rodriguez.
Take a look here how DJ Thomas comes off that screen and pulls up on a dime. Whaley sets the screen and he, boom.
Defending the D inside. Remember, Whaley's got four fouls. Four on the shot clock. The D step back. And not this time doing the rebound. 5.5 to play.
You got to step up on that screen right away if they're setting for Thomas.
Boom, that's an off-balance jumper that goes.
Tough shot. I mean, they're just doing enough to hang in there, UNLV.
Back to a two-possession game. And the UNLV fans trying to make some noise here in their home building.
Now they changed up the zone a little bit, more of a 1-2-2, which I like better. They need to pack it in around this kid.
Ladee halfway down and out. Offensive rebound again. Parrish rejected by Boone.
See, that's the problem, Andrew. You play zone, it becomes a lot harder to defensive rebound because you're in an area, you don't have a guy.
22 offensive rebounds for San Diego State. 23 rebounds total for UNLV.
It's brutal.
And Brian Dutcher calls timeout. As a reminder, Jerry Palm has six Mountain West teams in the NCAA tournament field, including San Diego State. They do not have, he does not have UNLV in, meaning UNLV would have to win this tournament on their home floor. So, 6-point deficit with 4:39 to play. Here's a look at the resume for the Runnin' Rebels. Jerry Palm has them out. They did beat Creighton. But they have three quad four losses.
Yeah, those are brutal. Like I said, Air Force game here was really bad.
If this result holds, I'm not sure what's the more impressive streak, that San Diego State would beat UNLV in the conference tournament for the 9th consecutive time, or this would be the 17th straight year that San Diego State has won its first game at the Mountain West Tournament.
I mean, they're both very, very impressive. There's no doubt about it. I know Gonzaga has won that many also. And I believe Toledo, which I would never have guessed in a million years.
And Toledo lost today.
Oh, their streak is gone.
So it's over.
Now they're going man-to-man. They need to stop here.
Here's Ladee, right back to Powell. He'll launch a three. Short. Ladee had it out of bounds. It's UNLV basketball.
You know, they got away with one there because Whaley did not box Ladee out that time. He came in all by himself.
Noel to Whaley at midcourt.
Whoa.
That was ambitious.
Look at that. They're trying to deny Thomas the ball, making him really work just to get it.
Boone is good. That's a three for the moment. They may take a look at that one. But for the moment, it's a three-point game. 7 straight points for the Rebels.
Back to this 1-2-2 zone.
Ledee from the free throw line has not been able to get it going the last couple of minutes, and the Rebels take over.
Double pick and roll for DJ Thomas.
Thomas had it knocked away out of bounds. It'll be UNLV basketball when we come back. 3:20 to go. And the Rebels are not going away quietly. They're on a 7-0 run against San Diego State. Now let's switch to easy mode for the Geico play of the game. And right before the half, a UNLV turnover, and Darion Trammell hits the three, and the game really changed at that point.
There's no doubt about it. You knew when it happened, instead of an 8-point lead, they were controlling the whole last 5 minutes, and they end up going into the locker room with a 5-point lead.
A 41-30 run since that buzzer beater to close out the first half. It was a 3-pointer by Boone, so it is a 3-point game with 3:20 to go. One timeout left for the Rebels, 2 for the Aztecs. Thomas gets it into Rodriguez. Shot clock's at 8. Whaley defended by Ledee. Whaley goes right at Ledee. Great defense by Ledee.
Really good D. Whaley's really had a tough time inside on Ledee.
Now on this end of the floor, the Aztecs are 1 for their last 8. They have not scored in the last 3-plus minutes.
They're struggling with the zone lately, and they switched it up. Not in that 1-3-1 anymore, and that is hurt. Oh, what layup.
Butler has a freeway to the hoop.
Oh, wow. Against the zone. Not supposed to see that.
Back to a 2-possession game.
Tell you, Butler, you see why he's a defensive player of the year.
Noel, no good. Whaley had the ball, and Kevin Kruger wanted a foul. No call.
Great hustle by Jay Powell there to track that ball down.
Kevin Kruger saying, guys, settle in. No fouls. Let's play good defense as we approach 2 minutes to play.
Man to man.
Five to shoot. Powell for 3. And another offensive rebound to Parrish.
And that time, DJ Thomas had a body on him, but it was a long rebound and that size difference.
San Diego State plus 20 on the glass. Butler. Yes. Big shot for Lamont Butler.
And he's a big shot maker.
64-57. Butler's got a dozen. Whaley inside, and he's got a field goal. That's his first of the day. He was 0-for-5 prior to that shot. How do you play it now, Lap?
You don't have to foul yet. You just got to go solid defense here. I don't know if I would go zone, though, because now these guys are just going to hold it out, no problem. I would be playing man-to-man here without trying to foul. But now it's too easy for them to just hold the ball. That's what I don't like about this defense right now.
Butler again is not there, and Boone comes the other way.
Got to attack quickly.
30 seconds to go. Here comes Thomas.
What a shot.
Off the window. Three-point game. Shot clock turned off, and Kevin Kruger calls timeout.
I'll just say, I think he needs to use his last timeout there.
And he does. Might have to look at the clock and put a little bit back on.
It's still going to be a last. They're going to have to
correct.
Foul.
Yes. Yes.
No matter what, whatever they put back on. Wow. Look
wow,
at Whaley
looks like
here.
Whaley was out.
And DJ Thomas coming off that screen. It's good to screen in this situation because it gets Butler off of him.
Yeah.
Which is probably the best thing.
And they do add a little bit of time, 29.3 on the clock.
Yeah, I mean, you have time to set up your pressure. If you want to just, if you want to get some traps in the backcourt, that's fine. As soon as it comes into the front court, you have to foul.
Possession arrow favors San Diego State, and the Aztecs still have two timeouts remaining.
Let's keep in mind, too, one of the guys who handles the ball for San Diego State, Levon Butler, is a 56% free throw shooter. My guess is he'll be taking the ball out of bounds. Reese Waters is now in the game, 92% free throw shooter. Levon Butler is taking it out.
Yep. It'll be Keelan Boone defending the inbound. The winner will take on Utah State tomorrow night in the semifinals. Butler to Ladie. And there's the foul given by Justin Webster.
Well, he's not a bad guy to foul either. He hasn't, you know, he's had his struggles at the free throw line tonight.
It's 5 of 10 from the line. He will get two shots to try to make it a two-possession game. 26 points and 14 rebounds today for Jaden Ladie. Big one coming here.
And no matter what he does here, whether it's three or four, UNLV has 27 seconds. They don't have to force a three. It's going to be a two-possession game if he makes this. Get a quick two. Set up your pressure again.
Oh, it rattles in. A four-point lead.
Got to take it quickly, though.
Thomas. From the free throw line, another one.
And now you got a foul right away.
Thomas ties a career high with 25. And Brian Dutcher will call timeout.
That helps. That helps UNLV,
sure.
I believe, in that situation. Because they weren't really set up in their pressure. Now they're going to set up their pressure. That's a great shot.
You think about this kid, 18 years old, as we've said, should be a senior in high school, reclassified to play here at UNLV. The poise and maturity that he plays with at the age of 18 is truly remarkable, and he's got 25 points today.
Now, it's unbelievable because the kid, too, doesn't change his expression. He doesn't get mad. He doesn't get happy. He doesn't get anything. You know, he's like, he's cool, calm, and collected.
That's what Kevin Kruger told us, that they expected maybe some type of learning curve. But he's been so consistent, doesn't get too high or too low all year. Evan?
And Kevin Kruger dropped some high praise in a comparison to Trey Young, somebody he coached at Oklahoma. And I talked to DJ yesterday. His guy growing up, his idol, who he's modeled his game after, Chris Paul. And you can see some of that in the way he attacks the game.
Yeah, there's no doubt. I mean, you know, you talk about Trey Young. I agree. You know, when he first came out tonight, I was like, kind of reminds me of him a little bit.
Once again, it will be Butler to inbound for San Diego State. Well, Aztecs still have one timeout.
They got to do their best tonight. Let Reese Waters catch this ball because he's 92%. even though he has not played a lot.
Butler to Trammell.
You got a foul. Foul him. Oh, they had Butler.
They had Butler, and Kevin Kruger saying, we fouled Butler. You didn't call it. That's who they wanted to foul.
You know what, though, Andrew? They didn't do a great job of getting to him quickly and really selling it, I don't think. I mean, he's a 56% foul shooter. This is the guy you want to foul.
Yeah.
No, I, you know.
You're right.
They didn't come quick enough.
They should have attacked him.
As soon as he caught it, it should have been on him.
Now it's Parrish, who's 73%. As a team, San Diego State 61% from the line today.
Another miss.
The Rebels will have a chance. Well, the first game went to overtime. Will we get another one?
Brian Dutch bringing in his defenders. Jay Powell and Miles Bird.
Missed them both. Noel the rebound.
Thomas got to go. And you go to the basket.
Down by two. No timeouts for UNLV. Fans on their feet. 5 seconds left.
What's he going to do?
Thomas with two. Thomas at the horn. He's got it! 0.5 on the clock.
What a shot.
Aztecs do have a timeout. They're not going to call it. Butler at the buzzer. No good, and we are going to overtime. Dedon Thomas Jr., a career high 27.
What a shot. I mean, I thought he wasn't going to get anything. Look at this.
And five more on the clock in Vegas. San Diego State 65, UNLV 65. As we look at the bracket in the Mountain West, the first game went to overtime. Utah State won. This game, overtime, with the Aggies awaiting the winner. Fifth overtime game of the year for the Aztecs. They're 2-2. Third for UNLV. They are 1-1. DJ Thomas has had a day, 27 points. That's a new career high. 4 assists and only 2 turnovers.
No, you know, that's the thing. 2 turnovers against San Diego State, and he's got the ball in his hands the whole game. The whole game controls everything for UNLV. He has been spectacular.
It was a 10-point lead for the Aztecs in the second half late, 60-50. Since then, San Diego State 2-for-10, and UNLV went 7-for-9 to tie it. And here we are in OT.
And changing up that zone, it's going to be UNLV ball. Changing up that zone from the 1-3-1 to the 1-2-2 really helped. They struggled with that look.
And certainly, Lapp, you got to point to the free throws as well. They have really hurt San Diego State. Just 55%. They've missed 9 free throws today.
Ladie and Parrish missed 3 out of 4.
Five to shoot. Thomas defended by Butler.
Got to shoot it.
Out to Boone. Boone doesn't get it off in time. That's a shot clock violation. Twelve turnovers by the Rebels, 11 for San Diego State.
Back to that 1-3-1 again. No. Well, the 2-3, 1-2-2.
Parrish. And another offensive rebound. This time it's Powell. Tough pass. Travel out of bounds. Offensive rebounds for San Diego State. UNLV as a team has 27 rebounds.
They've been all over the glass, which they out-rebound their opponents by. They have one of the best rebound margins in the country.
That is a season high in offensive rebounds for the Aztecs. To the basket, off glass for two.
I'll tell you, he's had a pretty good second half, too.
17 on the day for Boone. And 13 have come after halftime.
This is an interesting defense. DJ Thomas is in the back line.
Butler.
Oh, not a good shot.
And the rebound to Noel. UNLV has made its last five field goals in a row.
That's what you want. You want to switch. You want to get Butler off of him. Just like that.
Now Powell on Thomas. Thomas Ooh. Spinning on Powell, and he draws the foul.
Yeah, I mean, you see clearly that when he's got Butler on him, it's a little different than when they get the switch. Set the screen, switch. Now he's got Jay Powell on him, who's a good defender, but he's not Lamont Butler.
That's number four on Powell. And Brian Dutcher is talking to Lamont Butler maybe about that very point, Lap.
Maybe they're not going to switch anymore. Because I think Kevin Cougar's playing for the switch. This kid has one tight handle, I'll tell you that.
29 for DJ Thomas with his dad watching on. This matches the best scoring output by a Rebel this year. Caleb Boone had 29 against New Mexico. It's a 12-1 run for UNLV.
Man to man now.
From Mel, tough two.
Yeah, that was, you said it right there, Andrew. Tough two.
And they needed that.
That was a strong drive. Let's see what happens. He set the screen, get the switch, and then take somebody. That's basically what's going on now. Oh, they didn't switch that.
Yep, Butler's on him. Kevin Kruger wanted a foul, 10 to shoot.
We'll try it again, let's see what happens.
Here it comes.
No switch.
Yep, that was the message. Now Thomas for three, short. And the rebound, Noel's got it. Had it poked away. Looked like he was complaining to the ref.
Yeah.
And when he was complaining, it was knocked out. Waters rejected by Boone. Yeah, that's his fourth block.
What was Noel doing? Yeah, he looked like he was gonna complain to the ref about something. He's got the ball in his hand. He's saying I got fouled.
And then Saunders poked it away.
I mean, are you kidding?
And then Boone the other end.
How about complaining on a dead ball?
Good pass. Let's see, rejected, but a foul. Rodriguez was looking for the tie-up. Instead, he's whistled for the foul. And that's the fourth on Rodriguez.
Oh, boy. That looked pretty clean.
Well, this has not been a friendly spot for the Aztecs today. The free throw line. Ladido makes the first. Twenty-nine for Thomas. The winner will play Utah State tomorrow night.
I think that this kid's going to have to deal with Lamont Butler. Fifth-year senior, all defense. Defensive player of the year.
Thomas, the dish to Raley. What a find from DJ.
Well, you know what happened? He had two guys on him, so somebody was going to be open.
90 seconds left. Rebels up by two.
They want to get it to Ladie, no doubt.
Whaley's got him with four fouls. Here comes the help from Boone. Ladie trying to split through. And a travel.
Watch this pass. He knows he's there. He draws all the help.
And Whaley and Boone giving Ladie problems. It's Rebels basketball. 1:15 to go.
Yeah, I like what UNLV is doing, doubling him hard with Keelan Boone.
One minute left.
Oh, they switched it.
And Thomas lost it going up. Taken away, Ladie. And he's fouled from behind. Not a smart foul. It'll be two shots, and that's the fifth on Noel. Noel,
yeah, that's
at midcourt. You can see that Boone was back. Rodriguez was getting back. It was not an odd number break. But now it'll be two free throws for the Aztecs. All of these fans standing at the Thomas and Mack Center, which has been a second home for San Diego State. They've won 13 of their last 15 in this building, and 8 straight in the conference tournament against UNLV. Ladie makes the first.
Feeling a little better now.
You don't see it a lot in college basketball, but if he makes this, do you think 2-for-1?
No. It's so hard to get a good shot against San Diego State. If you think you're going to get a good one off in 10 seconds.
I missed a second anyway.
Yeah.
So now you want to use some clock. 1-point lead. 10 missed free throws today for the Aztecs.
Got an 18-second differential. So, yeah, you want to use some clock now. And you want to get something going to the basket so that at least you get to the free throw line.
Thomas at Saunders, off-balance shot, no good. The rebound fought for, and it's San Diego State basketball.
He got bumped on that, I thought.
They can take a look at the monitor, and I believe they will, to make sure that it was last touched by UNLV.
Took a tough shot there.
Whaley underneath.
It's off his foot, right?
I think it was last off of Whaley's leg.
I certainly like who took the shot in DJ Thomas, just didn't get a good one.
That's the only look we have. An official review, 21.5. Thank you so much for your
support of Mountain West Basketball. They called it San Diego State's ball, right?
Correct. There'd have to be conclusive evidence to give it the UNLV.
I mean, if it's San Diego State's ball, they're going to get this ball into Ladie, and he's going to get fouled. That's what's going to happen. And he's going to shoot two foul shots, and then it's just a matter of making it or not. But that's what's going to happen.
Our crew is Randy McCall, Randy Richardson, and Justin Chamion.
All obviously a huge call.
Well, this is serving as a timeout for both teams. They both head coaches had the clipboards out.
They're getting ready for both.
I think it's off Whaley's leg.
I do too.
And it is, yeah. San Diego State basketball.
Well, your UNLV, I'm not crazy about zone in this situation. I'd be man to man. You just don't want to leave a. Yeah, and it looks like they're going man-to-man. When you go zone, you leave too many areas open for a shot. They're going man-to-man now, and you know where this ball's going. It's a matter of how they're going to get it to him, to Ladie. It's going to be an up screen here.
Ladie, defended by Whaley. Ladie quickly for two. Aztecs up by one.
You got to take it quick.
10 seconds left. Rebels do have a timeout. Thomas has had the hot hand all day. Thomas short, rebound Ladie, and the foul with 2.7 on the clock.
That was a great call by Brian Dutcher. They ran an isolation, not getting it to him in the post. They got him to the elbow, cleared out the side. He goes great to his right hand, and he's able to take it to the basket. It fits right here. They clear it out. This is an isolation for Ladie. Nobody's there. Great call by Brian Dutcher, and a heck of a shot by Ladie.
32 points and 16 rebounds for Jaden Ladie, the senior from Houston, and now he's back at the free throw line. And he makes the first. Keep in mind, Rebels have a timeout, and they will use it right here. With 2.7 on the clock.
I will say this, Andrew, that if San Diego State goes up three, if the ball gets thrown to midcourt on the inbound, you foul. They throw it in the backcourt, you don't foul. So it depends on how far they're able to advance the ball, whether you foul or not. Obviously, if he misses this, you definitely don't want to foul.
Ladie is 10 of 17 at the free throw line today. Brooklyn Hicks, a freshman from Seattle, is on the floor, along with Justin Webster. A couple of guys who have some range. The team makes them both. 3-point game. And Brian Dutcher will call a timeout. Ladie has tied his career high with 34 points.
Number one, you got to put a guy on the ball. Can't let him just stand there and size everything up. There's got to be a guy. San Diego State has to put their biggest guy, a guy like Jay Powell, who's a very long, on the ball to make that pass as hard as you can. Then you got to hope. You got to make sure if the ball goes to half court, now there's no. If you want to go for the ball and foul, so that's fine. Then they go to the foul line. So be aggressive going after this ball if you're San Diego State. And if you don't worry about fouling.
All season long in the Mountain West, there have been some crazy finishes. Some wild things that just make you say, how does this always happen in this league? Are we about to see another one of those moments?
Nobody on the ball. If they're not going to, well, they better not throw it in the backcourt. They got to throw this up.
Thomas has trouble getting it. Now he's got it. Thomas at the horn. No! And the Aztecs survive. It nearly went in for Thomas to force a second overtime. But instead, San Diego State is back in the semifinals.
They got a really good shot. And they threw it in the backcourt. San Diego State decided not to foul, and this kid is so fast with that. Well, they got it up there pretty good. I mean, he got as good a shot as you're going to get in 2.5 seconds.
It's the ninth straight time that San Diego State has defeated UNLV in the Mountain West Conference Tournament. The Aztecs are back in the semifinals. And for UNLV, another year where they fail to get to the Mountain West semis. They have not been there since 2014. So we update the bracket. Each of the first two games going to overtime. It's the top seed Utah State advancing to play number 5 San Diego State tomorrow, 9:30 Eastern, here on CBS Sports Network. Coming up next, it'll be Nevada against Colorado State in the first game of the night session here at the Thomas and Mack Center.
I tell you, that was some day. I would say some game, some day.
Some performance by DeDon Thomas Jr. 29 points, forced overtime, but could not force a second OT. And Evan is with Jaden Ledee.
Jaden, congratulations. That was an incredible game. Let's go back to, you guys are down one with about 20 seconds to play. What was the thought? What was the intent with the play that ended up being the game winner for you guys?
It was a little isolation play Coach drew up. We had the bag. We ain't been brought it out in a while. So it kind of took him by surprise, a little sweep right, get to the paint, and, you know, I just, you know, made the shot.
What's going through your head in those moments?
Just, you know, play the game, you know. Really nothing, just instincts, you know. Just go out there and play your game, and, you know, I just did what I practiced 1,000 times.
Whether it was your performance or this team as a whole, what you guys did on the offensive glass, what's it say about where you guys are as a group right now, obviously in a critical time of the season?
I mean, it's what we do. We get better in March. I mean, this team beat us, what, nine days ago? So we kind of had a chip on our shoulder coming back, and just, you know, we owed him one.
Utah State awaits. Your thoughts on that one?
You know, they're a great team. We're going to go game plan tonight, and we're going to come out and just play hard and compete.
Congratulations. We'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow. Thank you.
34-16 for Ledee. So for Steve Lapis, Evan Washburn, our entire crew, I'm Andrew Catalan saying so long from Vegas, where the Aztecs are moving on. Let's send it to Adam Zucker in New York for Inside College Basketball. Bracket Week presented by Kubota. It's right after this break. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports.